Good morning, students. Today, our next topic is string handling functions. So, in the previous video, I have discussed about the basics of strings and what is the definition of string, how we can declare one string, how we can give the value of one string, that is called as declarations and initialization part of string. Then we have seen about how to at the time of compilation and at the time of runtime, how we can give the values of string. So that is what we have discussed in the previous video. In this video, we are going to discuss about string handling functions. Okay. So what are the string? There are some defined already user defined built-in functions available about end string. Those are declared in string.h header file. So what our ambition is, how we can manipulate one string. If you want to copy the one string to another string, or if I want to merge two strings together, or if I want to count the number of characters in one string. So these are the basic common popular manipulating functions involved in string. So those are comes under the topic of string handling functions. Okay, that is what we are going to discuss it now. Okay, so what is our first manipulation we are going to see about in string means we are going to count the number of characters in a string. Say for example, this my name is one string. It is an input string. I want to count number of characters in my string. Suppose our college is a one string, that is an input string, means I want to count the number of characters. This is my task and this is my motive. Okay, in that one, I'm going to write a program. You can see the PPT. The first line in the C program is obviously hash include. So in that we are using stdio.h, that is the basic things, and conia.h also we are using. Then we have started the main. So after starting the main, what is our first task? We have to analyze the input strings and output strings. That is part a declaration part. Okay, in the declaration part, according to our concept, what is the input? Only one input. We are going to scan one string. In that string, we are going to count the number of characters. So that is what declared in as character input string of 50. 50 is my nominal size. As an example, I have taken my string as with a size of 50. Then I have declared one integer. I equal to 0, then length equal to 0. These are called as initialization part. I already declared what is mean by declaration and what is meant by initialization. So here we are initializing the integer variable with some values. Say for example, I equal to 0 is the initial value for integer I. Then length equal to 0 is the initial value for length variable. Okay, so these are the preambles, prerequisites which are needed to implement my task. Okay, fine. So now I have going to scan one integer. So what is the input operations to scan one string? Getters. Okay, using getters function, I have scanned my input. So that input is stored in my variable input underscore string. Okay, now I got the inputs. Then what is the next statement I have to do using while loop? Here using while loop, I'm going to count the number of characters. Okay, what is the test condition I'm giving in while loop? I want to count the number of characters from the starting of the string to end of the string. Okay, from the starting of first letter, first character in the string to last character in the string. That is my ambition. Okay, in that task, what is my test condition? This while loop should be executed till the null, till it reaches to null. So that is what the test condition is given here. The input string of I is not equal to null. Not equal to null means I want to increment the length. Okay, I want to increment the length and I have to increment the I counter variable also. Length is nothing but to store the final length of the string. I use the counter variable to increment till it reaches to some conditions. What is the condition here? It should be processed till it reaches the null. So that is what given here. Very simple one. Just input string is not equal to null. I'm incrementing the length and I'm incrementing the height. Okay, that is what given in the while loop. Then after the while loop executions, what it will store? The length will store the exact length, exact number of characters in a string. So that is what going to printed in the printf statement. The printf, the length of your text is percentage d characters length. Okay, here what it will print means, it will print the final number, total number of characters in a string. Okay, this is manually done. This process is we are writing the program to count the number of the strings. So this is already available in your string.h header file. What is the built-in function we are using means strlen, that I will discuss in the next video. Okay, so but as a basic thing, as a beginner, you must know how to count the number of characters in your string. Okay, so this is an example. Okay, next we move to another one manipulation about the string, that is called copying one string to another string. Okay, so now what I am going to do means, I am going to count the I am going to copy the one string value into another string. Okay, so I have one string, I'm scanning one string, I want to copy this string to another one string for my purpose, for my general purpose. So that is my task. Okay, I have written the program. You see the first part, it is an inclusion part. We have included stdio.h and then conio.h. Okay, these are the two common header files we have included. Then I started the main program. Okay, after the main program, what is the first part? It may be a declaration part or initialization part. Okay, here what is my logic? I want to copy one string to another string. So for that, you need two strings. You need two string variable that should be declared as character of array. Here I have taken the variable name as copy and paste. Copy is my original string, paste is my destination string. In that, for my understanding, I have given the variable name as copy and paste. And then one more variable I'm using, that is called as integer variable, to maintain the loop. To maintain the loop, I have declared one integer variable. So as of now, we have declared one source string and destination string and one counter variable. That is the second, that is the next line in your program. Then I have used CLRAC here to screen my screen. Okay, then using printf statement, I have written one statement, enter your name to copy. Then using getTest function. Using getTest function, I have scanned my input string that is stored in the variable copy. Okay, I already told that copy is my original string, paste is my destination string. Okay, now I have scanned the original string. Then what is the next topic? I want to copy the original strings into destination string. So each character in the original string should be copied into the destination string. Okay, for that I am using for loop here. What is the concept I am using? For loop, because that is the best and easy to understand and simple technique to using the looping concepts. So for that I have used for loop. What is the we know that for loop consists of three parts. What is the first part? It is an initialization part. So what is the variable we are using here is I is turned to, are initialized to 0. Okay. Then what is the next part? It is a condition part. What may be the condition for this case? At last, when this copying should be continued, when it should be end means it, when it reaches to null. When it reaches to the, when the original string reaches to null, this copying process should be carried out. So what is the test condition here? The copy of I should not be less. It should not be less only, this copying process will be carried out. When it reaches to null, the copy process will not be carried out. So it should exit from the loop. That is my logic. So that is what the condition is given here. Copy of I is not equal to 0, not equal to null. This should be continued. Then what is the third part? obviously is an incremented part, so we are incrementing by one by one because I need to copy all, I need to copy all characters in a original string to destination string. I should not neglect any one character. I should copy every continuous characters should to be in destination string. Okay, so that is what that is my concept. That's what it is given as I++. Okay, fine. Now I have written the for loop statement. Then what should be the body of the loop? What should be the task in the looping statement? Means I want to copy each character from copy string to paste string. We have the two variables. So copy of I should be pasted into paste of I for each iteration. That is what the single statement we have written here. So copy of I in the right side should be assigned to paste of I in the left side. Okay, fine. So now we have copied. Then at last I should tell that the destination file should end with null. So in that last line I have to include null in the last line. So that is the last statement after the for loop have written here. Paste of I is equal to null. Okay, now I have copied. Then what is the next step? I have to be, that should be printed. So how we can print? Using printf statement or put as character, or else you can in the two ways you can display the destination string. So here I have used printf. The name is printed as a convenient statement I have written, and that put as of paste. Finally I have printed the paste, that is the pasted string from original string. Okay, so in that way we are copying the content of one string into another string. That is a second manipulation function possible in string. Okay, so dear students, as of now we have discussed about counting the number of characters in one string and how to copy one content of one string into another string. So this is the two basic string manipulation functions in the string concept. So I'll catch you in the next video about the remaining manipulation functions. Okay, I hope you understand these concepts. I catch you in the next video. Bye, take care.